So if you're around and you haven't checked in yet, come see this tall man. Yay, welcome. Okay, get your popcorn and soda and get to your tables, teams. We're gonna get started. So while you guys are getting settled, I'll let you know what this is all about for those of you who are kind of tuning in and don't know. My name is Tessa White. Happy to be here. I work here at the libraries. And this is POW Pitch of the Week. This is our first event of this. We're doing it every Wednesday of the month from 12 to 1. We have these teams. Our teams are full up until the 19th. So if you're watching today and you want to get on a team, you can sign up at the LibGuide, which is on all the promotional materials that we have around and that you can pick up at our service desk as well. So I'm going to explain the game and then we'll get started. So each of our teams will be given a random prompt and 20 minutes to devise a pitch based on the prompt. Now this can be an idea for an invention, a product, or a service, a solution to a pressing problem, or anything else that speaks to the prompt. Feel free to get creative and weird, guys. I just added the weird thing, just because I like weirdness. If you do too, if that speaks to you, then go to town. If it doesn't, that's fine too. So the teams will be judged on their teamwork, communication, and creative thinking. These are our judges right here. I'll introduce them and their impressive credentials later. The teams can use the internet to help brainstorm, and they will also have tools like PowerPoint or Tableau or whichever one they want to employ to use as they put together their pitch. They can choose any method. Right, they can choose to not use anything and just present old school style. Before technology, what? Who knows that time? Not me. So here are our URLs to pay attention to. The top one is our Facebook live stream. We're live, you guys, on Facebook, UT Arlington Libraries, right over here. What's up, Facebook? Facebook.com/UTA Libraries. If you just like the UTA Libraries page, then you can see it. I think you can see it without liking it. I'm not really sure. Also, this is the URL for our YouTube channel, where the video is going to be archived, youtube.com/user/UTA Library. And then we also have a URL for you to vote on your favorite team and their pitch as they're doing it. We'll be taking live streaming. Do we have a live feed of that as well, Martin, today, of the poll? Do we have a live stream of the poll today? Okay, great, awesome. So that's up here as well. For those of you who can't see that, that's pollev.com/MartinWallace439. All right. So this is where we're going to have you guys each draw a card from the deck of cards that are in front of you on your tables. And each deck has a different situation. The first one is a discipline, second one is a tool, and the third one is a material. I'm not actually sure which one is which, but you guys will just pick one from the deck. You can pick off the top or in the middle, up to you. And then we'll announce what you guys picked, and that will be your prompt. So go ahead and take one of the cards out of your pile. Yeah. You can shuffle, you can get crazy with it. Martin is gonna write what you come up with. Oh, we're gonna start the 20, oh, we start after we do the prompt, all right. Oh, this says no signal. Technical difficulties. All right, what did you guys get? All right, this is the discipline. It's video game programming. Interesting, relevant, thank you. What'd you guys pick? All right, this is the equipment. Arduino. What is that? I definitely don't know. Did I pronounce it right? Okay, cool. And our material is liquid latex. Nice alliteration there. Liquid latex is the material. Potential to get weird, I think. This has a lot of potential to get interesting. Discipline, video game programming tool, Arduino, material, liquid, latex. Okay. What do you need? Look at that. It's a programming tool. Oh, yeah. So we're gonna start the 20-minute timer, and that's when you get to start doing your research and figuring out your pitch, all right? So, does anybody have any questions before we get started? You know what's up? You ready to roll? All three. Your pitch has to include all three things. Cool? Okie doke, guys. We're gonna start the 20-minute timer now. Woo, exciting, 20 minutes. Create amazingness. So while they're working, I'm gonna introduce our teams. We're gonna maybe do a little random trivia. There's candy involved if you get the right answer. Maybe, probably if you don't, because it's random stuff. But first I'm gonna introduce our team one. This is the Ralph Wiggum Society. Y'all know who Ralph Wiggum is? I had to look it up because I don't really watch The Simpsons. Don't hate me. But this is the Ralph Wiggum Society. Vivian, you're Vivian, right? This is Vivian De La Cruz, a junior advertising and public relations major. Felix Diaz is a junior broadcasting major. And Elaine Otstadt, did I say that right? Yay. Is a junior kinesiology major who minors in public health. The Ralph Wiggum Society. You can clap if you want. I feel like that should happen because, you know, they're putting themselves out there. So now is the time for a little trivia inspired by each team. This is some Ralph Wiggum trivia. Any Simpsons fans out there? Yeah? Cool. So if you know who Ralph Wiggum is, do you know who his father is? Does anybody know who Ralph Wiggum's father is? You know? Who?
The Chief of Police.
Chief Wiggum, you're right. Candy for you. Good job, m'lady. Chief Wiggum was the right answer. I hope you like chocolate. All right. So here's another trivia item pertaining to Ralph Wiggum. Finish this quote. Me fail English? That's... What is it? Anybody? I know that's kind of a hard one because that could be several things. Nice! That's the right answer. You want some candy, sir? Here, I'll give you some nerds. Get it? All right, and the last one. What is Ralph Wiggum's cat's name? Anybody? Ralph Wiggum's cat's name. Just guess. It's not cat, but that would be funny. You can have some candy for that if you want, Andy. Just reach it in that basket. You can have some. Nobody knows? Nobody wants to guess? Crickets. That's not the answer. It's mittens. So now you know, if anyone ever asks you what Ralph Wiggum's cat's name, it's mittens, and nobody gets any candy. Sad. All right, team two, right here. What's up? I didn't see you when you came in. Welcome. Oh, you're a replacement. Okay. Cyril, okay. So I'm gonna start with you, Cyril. What's your last name? Lutterat. Cyril Lutterat. What's your major? Software engineer and psychology? Double major? Okay, major, minor, right on. And what year are you? Senior. Awesome. That's Cyril, part of our team, the Almost Invisible Cows. We'll get to that. And we have Reese Walker, a senior public relations major who is minoring in advertising, correct? Yes. And Seun Lee, did I say your name right? Okay, good. I'm sorry, I didn't get to meet you beforehand. Seun is a sophomore nursing major who minors in leadership. The Almost Invisible Cows, you guys. Now, if you're asking yourself, what are the invisible cows? Or what are the almost invisible cows? I had the same question. So I did some Googling and came up with some trivia. So if you don't know what invisible cows are, Martin knows. I think you might be the only one. So maybe someone else knows. Where does the invisible cow phenomenon exist? Ha ha ha, that's funny. He's at Chick-fil-A. That is funny. You should get candy for that, but that's not the answer. The answer is Hawaii. There are actually signs around in areas of the Mauna Kea access road that the sign actually says most of the Mauna Kea access road below Hale Pohaku is open cattle range and the cows frequently cross the road. Dark colored cows are often invisible in darkness and or fog. Use extreme caution and drive very slowly so you don't run over an invisible cow. Okay. Oh, yeah. All right, so nobody knew that. But you want some candy? You deserve some. You've been working hard, Martin. All right, yes, round of applause. How old can cows live to be? I'm just now in cow trivia. Anybody know how old can cows live to be approximately? Who said what? What'd you say, 35? That's close. But you guys are actually on a team, so you shouldn't really, you should be focusing. What did you say? 30, that's close. I'll give you some candy for that. It's approximately 25 years. I mean, you never know. Life is crazy. You're welcome. So this is also just a fun bit of trivia. You can guess the age of a cow that has horns by counting the number of rings on the horns. Didn't know that, did you? Now you do. Fun facts that you can impart to whoever will listen to you. All right, and team three, working diligently on our whiteboard column, they are called the Mighty Flying Penguins. Okay, we have a replacement, Kevin Cooper? Okay, great. So Kevin Cooper, that's you? I'm gonna come back here. I don't have your credentials to list out. What is your major?
Advertising.
Nice. And what year are you?
Junior.
Junior advertising major, Kevin Cooper, right here. Geraldine Palmer, did I say it right? Good. She's a freshman accounting major. Wonderful, thank you for joining us. And you're Michael. Frosto. A junior advertising major, right?
With a specialization in creative.
Right on! The Mighty Flying Penguins, you guys. Give them a round of applause. All right, so Flying Penguins trivia. Ready for it? Can penguins fly? Nice. You are right. Despite the fact that they have wings, they cannot fly. But they basically fly underwater, which is what their wing-like contraptions are for. They can swim up to 15 to 25 miles an hour underwater. Okay, does anybody know the name of the large, there are 18 penguin species. Does anyone know the name of the largest penguin species? You know? Yeah, that's our answer, Emperor. Come and get some candy. You want some candy? The Emperor Penguin. Yeah, sure. A guy in the blue t-shirt. Okay. So now I'm going to introduce our lovely judges. I did this in a practice run. I can't help but say judges in a British, stupid British accent because of So You Think You Can Dance and Cat Deeley. Because she goes, "Yo, judges!" And everybody says it with her and they love her, and that's why I do that. And it's like really nailing it here. So I'm gonna take a note to not do that next week. Kofi Salam Egbedo, right here. Give him a round of applause. Kofi is a technology licensing associate with the Office of Technology Management here at the University of Texas at Arlington. He received his bachelor's and master's degree from the University of Massachusetts at Lowell, where he studied electrical engineering and innovation in technological entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is not a word. Entrepreneurship is a word. Woo! I should practice that one, but I didn't. His work's mostly focused on the protection, marketing, and licensing of campus-created inventions and intellectual property. Very, very impressive. Welcome, Kofi. Yes, more applause, yes. Time check, you guys. We're right at 10 minutes, halfway through. Woo, 10 minutes. I wrote that song. Scott Parsonen, did I say that right? Awesome. Scott is a serial entrepreneur. I got to say it again. Good thing I practiced with Kofi's. Fledgling inventor and serious foodie. Scott is president and CEO of Parsonen Dental Ventures, LLC, a startup in the dental and biotech sector with big plans for global expansion. Good luck to you on that. While starting up his newest venture within the walls of the aptly named Startup Lounge at his beloved alma mater, the University of Texas at Arlington, Scott became an organizer at 1 Million Cups in Fort Worth, Texas, and founder of the Arlington House of Genius. Wonderful. Welcome, Scott. Yes, more applause. And last but certainly not least, our beloved Andy Herzog. He is one of our librarians here at UTA Libraries. He has been a librarian here for 6 years, correct? And he is the department head for our Faculty Services and Online Engagement Department. He very much enjoys helping students and working with faculty. Andy Herzog. All right, we're down to 8 minutes and 30 seconds, you guys. I can't believe the time is ticking down so quickly. All right, Asami, can you take a break from the popcorn scooping? This is the lovely Asami Nagakura, the Strategic Initiatives Coordinator of the UTA Startup Lounge, and she's gonna take a moment to do a little plug for the Startup Lounge if you guys don't know what it is. Asami.
Hi everyone, my name is Asami. I'm a grad student at linguistics department, but I also work at a startup lounge. For those you don't know where we are, it's on the west side of campus where you see Mac. And when you see Mac, just turn around, it's on your right. It's in campus center building, and you see the banner saying Startup Lounge. We help entrepreneurs. You don't have to be a student. It's open to anybody in community. And we have seminar series and workshops, and we have places for you to come and have meetings and work on your project. Actually, this is Wednesday, and we do have a seminar called Epic Maps. Every Wednesday at 5:30 p.m., today's topic is financial statement. It sounds scary, but we don't require any prior knowledge. So this is perfect place if you have nothing, if you know nothing about financials when it comes to startup business. I hope to see you there.
Thank you, Asami. Round of applause for Asami Nagakura. I said that right. And I need to practice all the names before the next time so that I'm not confirming pronunciation, although it does take up some time. We're at 6 minutes and 22 seconds, teams. 21, 20, 19. They're working hard. Magic is happening. I can feel it. For the people who are watching and following along, do you have ideas of what you would come up with for a pitch that includes video game programming, Arduino, and liquid latex? Anybody? What would you do? Come here. Candyman, you were the emperor guy, right? What's your name?
Nathan,
nice to meet you. What's your major?
Economics.
Right on. What year?
Junior.
Okay, awesome. Junior economics major. What would you come up with?
I'm sorry to add this for conditions. I wasn't sure whether or not the material might be physical product or could be virtual.
Well, I think that's part of the creation of it. Like, if it was virtual, I think you could go there. You could expand that way if you wanted to. I'm saying yes. Would you say yes to that? I guess it would be up to the judges, but what would you do?
Well, I couldn't think of any way liquid latex could actually be applied in terms of computer programming, so I tried to think of character design. So I was just thinking of, obviously, video game programming, video game tools, programming tools, so those go together well. And then I was thinking character design, we're working on liquid latex, using inspiration of Kirby, a soft gelatinous character who moves around using certainly unique physics and absorption.
That sounds awesome. That's a wonderful idea. Round of applause. So do you want to sign up for, right on, for the 19th? Okay, awesome. We'll see you on the 19th. We got a new team member. Did you guys come up with anything fun? No ideas? You're just hanging out watching the fun? That's cool too. Did you have any ideas? Yeah, you're thinking? I can come back to you if you want to share. If you don't, that's okay too. I want everyone to be comfortable with what's happening. You guys have an idea? What would you do with this? Tell me your name.
My name is Papa. Papa. Yeah. Thank you. Biology Junior. And support Cyril. Support Cyril. Support Cyril. Yeah, for robotics. That's it. Yeah, that's it.
You're not going to do your idea? All right. Do you know, are you interested in participating maybe in the team this month? Next month? Are you on? Well, we're not going to do it next month. We're doing it every Wednesday of month this month. So if you're interested, you can sign up over here. We still have spots for April 19th. And then the finals will be on the 26th. You can sign up online. Our lip guide. Do we have the lip guide up here? Let me announce the lib guide for you guys who are interested. If you don't know what a lib guide is, I can tell you what that is as well. We have a bunch of library guides on our website that are subject disciplines. And then we can also create them for fun events like this. And this one is libguides.uta.edu/POW. Pretty easy. libguides.uta.edu/POW. You can get more information about the creation and execution of this project and sign up if you like. There's a $10 incentive to participate, $10 gift card for your choosing. You choose what you'd like when you sign up. And then if your team wins today and gets to, or the day that you compete, you get to compete in the final round, which will be the last Wednesday of April. And the winning team for that gets a $50 gift certificate of your choice. Not just like anything that you can think of on the web, but there's a list of things you can choose from. I think it includes like Subway and no Subway. What is it? Amazon.
Amazon, Starbucks, Einstein Brothers Bagels, Baker Shed, or you can get $10 in printing funds. You get to select what prize you get.
Awesome, Einstein Bros, right here behind you in our library. We love the Einstein Bros. Hi guys. Thanks for the bagels and coffee. So good. Okay, we're down to 1 minute and 51 seconds. Ooh, I hope you're coming up with some magic. Clap it out. Yes, are you guys ready? You getting ready? It feels like super relaxed over here. You're like ready to go. Are you? You're on Instagram right now? Cool. You should Insta this. Take a do a live video of our live video. How meta can you get? I had to do it. Okay, we're down to 1 minute and 14 seconds. I did a little minor scale down. Jeopardy rocks. Sorry about that feedback. That didn't take up as much time as I was hoping it would. But I could do a different key. I'm kidding, I'm not gonna do it again. All right, just to remind everybody, our live stream here is facebook.com/UTA Libraries. You can vote on your favorite team as they're presenting, and after they've presented, at pollev.com/MartinWallace439. And then after our live stream concludes, it'll be archived on our YouTube page, youtube.com/user/UTA Library. Backslash is a hard thing to say, turns out. Forward slash, oh, because it is a forward slash. Thank you, sit by the timer. Forward slash, I mean, you know what a slash is when you're doing a URL, right? Wah, wah, yay, you guys, time's up. Woo, give our teams a round of applause. 20 minutes, that's not a long time to come up with magic. All right, so this is gonna be our judging period that will last for 25 minutes. Each team is gonna spend, you get 5 minutes per team to present your pitch. Martin's gonna keep the timer over here. After each pitch, judges, you can ask clarification questions if you have them. And then you guys will get about 5 minutes to converse and make your decision, and then we'll announce a winner. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. You're not gonna get a chicken dinner, but you could maybe like cash in your $10 thing, huh? You could buy a chicken dinner on Amazon. Smart, resourceful, we like that. All right, so team number one, are you guys ready? Okay, awesome. So do what you want, if you wanna stay back there or come up or whatever you've got planned. All right guys, Martin's gonna start your timer. Okay, the Ralph Wiggum Society is ready to go. You guys say the word. Oh yeah, they missed the mic. You guys want the mic?
Okay guys, go ahead and start, there you go. We designed a thing called the broom car kit. So what we did, we have a plot, a little warehouse that we turn into a racetrack itself. Everyone has an iPhone or a smartphone or anything like that that has capabilities of using VR. So what we did is in that VR, we used video game programming to go ahead and make a simulation as if you were actually in the vehicle that you were riding around in this virtual track in the phone, but it's actually in real life on when you go up to it. So it gives you, it has the application of not only doing it on your phone if you wanted to play it at home, but it has a racetracks where you can go and meet people, enthusiasts, people that actually like to customize the cars and everything like that. We're gonna go on to the first slide and we'll go further. So that's where I explained how the application of VR and real life application would come together. The virtual reality options would be custom cars, custom paint, adjustments to the speed and rate and everything like that. And then we'll go a little bit further on. The Arduino robot is the first robot on wheels made fun for everyone. So this gives you the option of coming out and not only just doing it at home, because there's a lot of games that you do just sitting around and customizing and upgrading. And, this makes it fun because you'll not only get to compete with people online, but you can also compete with people that are in person. We'll go ahead and go on. The liquid latex was actually something that we went ahead and, since it's fairly inexpensive, This customizes the glove to fit around a custom steering wheel. So when you show up, we have the steering wheel that controls, that'll sync to your car. And then at that point, you're able to fit the gloves in there and grab it. And you're actually driving as you're turning. You add a little couple buttons to speed boost, to slow down, to hit the brakes. And of course, this is gonna be a double layered course. So you have, you know, kind of the old school loop over around. It kind of gives you a cool feel, and you also get the different adjustments on the virtual reality. So we supply the headset, you bring your own phone. We have charging stations and everything like that. Go on to the next one. Oh, that's it? Oh yeah, I forgot. But yeah, that's something that we designed. Go back to the first slide. We did call it Room Car Kit. So that means that once you show up, not only do you have the capability of bringing your own car kit, which starts anywhere between $50 to $100. It's fairly inexpensive, but we also have car kits available for your purchase, and also upgrades that you can add on to it. And it does matter, because the tracks, sometimes if we have different tracks, you can go ahead and change the terrain up, different wheels and all that stuff. It makes it a little bit more interactive, less VR. And of course, all the gauges and everything goes up, and you get the sounds of the cars through our audio system. But this, again, would be the pitch that we came up with. Anyone want to say anything about it? Did I cover all the bases? Does anyone have any questions?
Anyone? Ralph Wiggum Society? Vroom Car Kit? No? I just wanted to say that like that.
It's fun, right?
It is fun. You try it. Do a good old vroom.
Vroom.
Yes! Great job, guys. Give them a round of applause. All right. Team the Almost Invisible Cows. You guys ready? Who wants the mic? Reese? You're all going to use it. You may all.
So, most everybody I know that's our age is a fan of video games. If you're not, then you really got to try it. It's amazing. But, the people who do play video games, you acquire skills in those video games. And those skills that you acquire, no matter what the base game is hand-eye coordination type of skills. And you learn how to use these interfaces, so to speak, these controllers. You learn how to use a joystick. You learn how to use buttons to move things in the way that you want to interpret that to the game itself. So, in these video games, though, most video games, I would argue almost all video games, what do you get out of it when you finish the game? You don't get anything. And that's the problem that most video game companies run into, is that they try to make their game so that they have more playthrough value, right? Replayability is a huge factor in making sure that people want to buy your game. So what if the video game that you're playing, when you beat it, you don't just say, well, do I want to play this video game again? What if at the end of this game, you come out with something tangible. You come out with something that you can use. You come out with something that you can take physically to your friends, to people who you want to introduce to this video game, and you want to say, look what I got from this, or look what I made from this. And our example for this, one of the many, is designing your own, well, designs and clothes and everything from using the Arduino program and fabricating things with liquid latex and using a joystick to do all of this. And I'm not so good with the technical side, but the possibilities are infinite when you can create it to whatever it is that you want to make. And guess what? If you make something and you get something at the end of it, what could give you more replayability? and for the technical side.
Hi guys. So as you illustrated, the Arduino device connects with the game controller, so you're able to have haptic feedback, and you're able to feel what you're clicking and what you're designing. Through that, once you create your device and it's rendered, you're able to output it through an Arduino. That Arduino then extrudes it in three dimensions. So like imagine a 3D printer, but just prints liquid latex. And you're able to have this feasible, tangible device that says, hey, I accomplished something. And based on that note, there's so many applicabilities for that. So let's say you wanted to go to a Comic-Con, or you wanted to go to a Halloween festival. You're able to provide these solutions from your game that you play, and you're able to provide custom designs that you want to use in your real-world environment. And she will explain more about the
So for the uses of the application, basically, like, let's say you want to go to an event, like AnimeCon or any kind of event. Game will also help you with like being active and just being able to know that, oh, you can bring this to life and make it feel like, oh, I'm being able to put this a part of me. Thank you.
And we call it Gamely. Gamely, G-A-M-L-I.
Gamely, that's awesome, guys. Do you have anything else you want to add? Judges, do you have any clarification questions for the Gamely pitch by the Almost Invisible Cows? I'm enjoying the juxtaposition that the Almost Invisible Cows create something very visible with their idea.
Cool, right? Oh my God, you guys. It's synergy.
Give them a round of applause. All right, the Mighty Flying Penguins, you guys ready? Who wants the mic first?
So you turn on your console, you notice that it starts to heat up. A win is within your grasp, but as soon as you're about to win, the console overheats and shuts off.
Overheating is one of the many issues in creating video game platforms today. It could lead to random shutdowns, random reboots, and random freezing within the games. And also it can eventually fry the motherboard.
And let me tell you, that's the most god-awful thing I've ever had happen to me. In the past, 10 years, there has been reported $30,000 in damages have been done strictly to overheating motherboards. Here's the one thing that they never truly considered, liquid latex. For the past year and a half, I worked in the theater art department with liquid latex on a daily basis, building everything from massive scars to nice little face masks. One day, I accidentally left it out, chilling on the sidewalk. I was like, crap, it's gonna be frozen, it's gonna be fried, it's gonna be too hot to the touch. Picked it up, and surprisingly enough, not. It was nice, it was cool, and even the ground underneath it was cool to the touch. Here's where we apply this. A layer of liquid latex over given computer elements. Doing this, you have the overheating issue that no longer goes directly to the motherboard, but will instead instill itself into the latex, which will then itself eliminate the liquid latex. Which reminds me, I just now noticed a theme between the judges. I like the hairstyle.
Nice.
We need bearded bald guy lunches. We need to get this done, gentlemen. So for anyone that ever hasn't played video games, game rage is no fun. It's terrible. And trust me, when you're living in a single bedroom apartment and your game overheats, your entire apartment overheats. Especially when you're too poor to afford AC. And your landlord's terrible and don't want to fix your AC. It doesn't make it any better. So what we want to do is we want to partner up with Arduino and Liquid Latex, combine them together. Arduino is one of the few companies that can actually be sold out and sell to everyone, and can actually be bought by consumers to build your own PC. Now what would be better? Going out of your way to go to Dell, Best Buy, Fry's, I love Fry's though, but they're expensive, and having to deal with all that, and then you still have an overeating issue, or go to Arduino, buy theirs, partnered with Liquid Latex, no overheating, no more crashing, and no more thousands of dollars of damages to a motherboard. Oh God, let's get this done.
Thank you. Great job, guys. Judges, do you have any clarification questions? You would be set. You're already set. Flattery will get you everywhere. And if I know nothing else, I know that frying the motherboard is a bad idea. Just, you don't want to fry the motherboard. No overheating for mother anything. If you're watching, Mom, I love you. All right, so. You guys watching, and if anyone's tuning in and wants to vote, you can vote for your favorite pitch of the week right now. We're gonna keep track of our user favorites while the judges are figuring out who they choose to be the winner. POLLEV.com/MartinWallace439. POLLEV.com/MARTINWALLACE439. Go ahead and vote for your favorite pitch of the week. You guys did an awesome job. I enjoyed that we had varying usages of technologies and presentations, including not using anything. The judges are judging. Did you see the pitches? Do you guys, are you voting right now? Anyone want to shout out? Well, I guess you can keep your favorites confidential. We don't want to make anyone feel bad. What is that, cobbler? Nice. Yes, I will mention that. So the judges are selecting the winner. And we're gonna use, and you can actually see the live polling right now. Can you? This might be blocking it. If there happens to be a tie amongst the judges, the user vote will determine the winner. That is only if there is a tie amongst the judges. If there isn't, the judges choose. But you still get to see what the users are preferring, and as you can see, it's fluctuating as we speak. Nobody knows who's gonna win or who's the favorite. What's important is everyone put in some awesome, intelligent, creative work today. Do we have a timer on the judging time? Okay. Just as a reminder, guys, if you're just joining us, this event is gonna happen every Wednesday of this month from 12 to 1, Rachia. And we have our teams are full for the next couple of weeks, but for at least next week, the 19th, I believe we have spots open in them. The 26th will be our final round with the winners from the first 3 weeks, the winning teams from the first 3 weeks. So if you're interested, go to libguides.uta.edu/POW to sign up. Or you could just come back and be an audience member, because we need that too. There's value in every part of this. You just don't get a $10 gift certificate unless you participate. But you will get popcorn and soda, which is always fun. All right, live polling is still fluctuating. Looks like a clear favorite amongst our viewers and audience. Who knows if it's the same with the judges? Only time will tell. I did it a lot lower earlier. That's what I get for going high. How are you guys doing on time? You're ready. Oh my goodness. Exciting. Is there a tie or is there a clear winner? All right, is everybody ready? First of all, I want to congratulate you guys on participating. Thank you for participating and coming up with some really awesome ideas. Creative, innovative, bright, wonderful. Awesome job, guys. Brave? Brave. Yes, very brave. Everyone's been very, very brave and vulnerable today. We love that. All right, so the winner of today's pitch of the week and the team that will be joining two other teams yet to be determined on April 26th is team number two, the Almost Invisible Cows. Yay! Awesome job, guys. Yay! Great job, guys. So we'll see you on April 26th. And everybody, everybody that participated today will get your $10 gift certificate of your choosing when you signed up. And so for our people who signed up today, make sure, did you walk them through the signing up to make sure you get your gift certificate? Guys, thank you so much for joining us today. I hope you come back for the rest of the month on Wednesdays from 12 to 1. Once again, I'm Tessa White, and I will see you next week. Bye.